Senator Ted Cruz likes to schmooze about being tech-savvy.
So I pulled out my phone, I sent a tweet.
But when he pulled out his phone aboard a flight to D.C., he got nabbed gazing at his Senate race rival, Beto O'Rourke. Politico posted the photos, inspiring mockery like this diary entry. I wonder if he thinks about me. Someone else called it humanizing. Who among us has not stared at a picture of Beto O'Rourke and gently caressed the picture with our thumb, added another, just like Senator Cruz seemed to do. Come on, get a grip. Cruz is probably just reading a news article about the race featuring his opponent's face. It's not Tinder. But there were plenty of Tinder jokes. Swipe left, swipe right. Beto O'Rourke's supporters look upon him as having the charisma of a Bobby Kennedy. Playing air drums to the Who as he drives through a Whataburger.
Thank you, too.
While Ted Cruz suffers the slings and arrows of late-night comedians.
I noticed that he looked like a blobfish.
The same day the in-flight photos were snapped, protesters at a D.C. restaurant hounded Cruz and his wife.
We believe survivors!
Chanting about the Supreme Court controversy, but adding insult to injury with this reference to his opponent's hotness.
Beto is way hotter than you do.
Not everyone found the phone photos funny. I have a problem with looking over someone's shoulder and reporting what documents articles they are reading. But Texas Democrats use the pictures to recruit volunteers. Even Ted Cruz is signing up to volunteer for at Beto O'Rourke. No, Cruz was not really cruising his rival. It just looks like O'Rourke is the wind beneath his wings. Genimo, CNN, New York.
And tonight, Cruz's campaign is having a little fun with this as well, giving us this statement. Breaking news. The airline passenger paparazzi captured the senator reading news clips about his campaign. Well played, Senator Cruz.